You can always depend on the nation's kids to throw a festive spanner in the Christmas works. And a lot of those spanners, rashes, slashes, bashes and splashes end up at a booking desk, just like this one.
ED department needs bacon sandwiches.
So, we've spent Christmas Day down at Sheffield Children's Hospital Accident and Emergency Department to experience the delights, the dramas and the festive pyjamas when you visit Casualty at Christmas.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love said to me, 12 pipers drum in heaven, pipers might make 10 lords of leaping fire, ladies dancing fame, fins of filthy servants, lords of spirits, cities, keys and lay. Four burly men,
three French hens,
two turtledoves, and an ostrich in a pear.
That's just the tiniest of teasers for what lies ahead this festive day. We kick off Christmas morn with this young man who seems to have lost his shoe.
Hi there.
Happy Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Jessie, what have you been doing?
I'm Josh Coles, I'm 10. I kicked a wall.
In excitement, kicked the wall and I heard a crack.
Christmas memories.
Joshua, come on through.
Those Christmas mornings when you go downstairs and find out that Santa's been. Once I punched the air, but I can't say that I've ever...
Kicked a wall.
Kicked a wall. Did you mean to kick a wall?
No.
What were you going for instead, football?
No. Don't know.
You don't know.
Now, boys always baffle me, and that didn't surprise me in the slightest.
Give your toes a wiggle.
Josh gets assessed in triage first.
Can you feel my touching?
Yeah.
Yeah?
He won't put any weight on it, that's what.
It's fine, you can pop your sock back on now.
Unfortunately, it involved his Christmas being spent in A&E.
Right, what should we put? Sat in A&E.
Christmas.
Joshua
Cole, our resident egg and spoon champion, hopped straight in from the waiting room, as many of our patients do.
Going to continue doing a hop, or
yeah,
do we need a wheelchair?
No, I'll continue.
Really?
No matter how many times you offer a wheelchair, they always refuse it. They prefer the one-legged hop.
Do you know what? I think you're doing that faster than you'd walk. Do you want to jump on here?
Okay.
Will this be too high for you? Oh, my gosh. Oh, wow. OK, you are amazing. Do you want to lie down, darling?
OK.
Okie dokie.
I think he became the world champion in hopping that day because he managed to hop all the way into A&E.
Now, I'm guessing you've had an accident.
And to every point, very successfully. And he did brilliantly well.
Are you able to curl your toes over for me?
Not without it hurting a bit.
No? OK. What about your ankle? Can your ankle go up and down, no problem? So, up and down, that's fine.
Kicking the wall was a bit silly because I don't know why I did it, although I was quite excited.
At least you don't have to saw my foot off.
Well, that's still a possibility.
If I were you, Shamani, I'd scan that.
Let's scan that, okay.
What, an x-ray?
Yep, we're gonna get a picture.
Okay.
Smile pretty for us. Let's go.
Okay.
Ready, careful. Should we lower the... Oh my goodness.
Hello, A&E reception.
Lovely Josh. He was so excited when he was opening his presents on Christmas morning, he kicked the wall.
Joshua Coles, and you've kicked a wall?
While Josh waits for his x-ray, Kath gives him some pain relief.
At the children's, we tend to use syringes to administer paracetamol and Nurofen. However, with Josh, I went to him and he thought it was an injection.
Is it an injection?
Just squirt it into your mouth. Some of the children love it, because they can administer on medicine and they think they're very grown up because of that.
Could you just confirm your birthday?
21st of December 2007.
And your name is?
Joshua Cole.
Fantastic, so you just had a birthday?
Yeah.
I just push that into your mouth.
Okay.
All we aim to do is to get the medicine into the child.
So birthday and Christmas in 1 week?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Special week for you then, isn't it?
Yeah.
Have you opened your present this morning?
Yeah.
Oh, nice ones?
Yeah.
Good. Happy?
Yeah.
Good.
Very.
If they're a bit more comfortable with the pain, it ensures that they get a better x-ray.
I love you, Mummy.
Yeah, I love you too. My number one man, he just makes me smile every day.
Sit, have a seat on the table for me. Make sure and swing your legs up. That's it, you can come in, Mum. I'll just get you to pop behind that screen for me.
You've been here loads of times. So now you should be there.
Who's she? The cat's mother? While Josh kicks back for his x-ray, get it? Kicks?
Every year someone thinks that we shall do a secret Santa.
I got some alcohol.
A candle as well.
Anybody it was so secret that I actually only found out today who my secret Santa was.
Can you tell the handwriting?
No, I literally can't.
Why is it not?
No, it's not mine.
Are you doing secret Santa?
No.
Are you ready for Top Trumps?
Somebody had brought it in as a stocking filler from their Secret Santa.
Fanny, are you playing Top Trumps?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. Deadly diseases, Top Trumps.
Thank you.
We learned a bit about infectious diseases and the difference between malaria and Ebola.
Oh, come on. I've got rotavirus, discovered in 1973.
I've got the hantavirus, I was discovered in 1950.
I didn't do very well. I'm pretty sure Deirdre won Top Trump's diseases.
I've got MRSA in 1960.
I win. I get all the cards. Oh, amazing, amazing. Love it already.
But then she's got so much experience, so she was going to win.
Woot, woot. Oh, I win, I'm the most fatal of all the diseases. Top trumping, you lot.
It was rigged.
That's slander, Shemani. I tell you who doesn't cheat, elves. And here's a contender for best dressed nurse.
Susan's a senior staff nurse in the department.
So I decided to dress as an elf.
A shadow is a little girl who came to hospital after a piece of glass cut her wrist. She was at home enjoying Christmas and drinking some juice out of a champagne flute like grown-ups do.
She sort of did a cheers and broke the glass and cut her wrist. Sometimes you can have children come in, they'll have massive bandages on and parents will be telling you about massive cuts. You take the bandage off and there's nothing. There was actually quite an impressive wound to what we normally get in.
I got made aware of her when Susan came through having requested an x-ray.
Because I triaged her and it was a cut with a piece of glass, I could send her straight round for x-ray without waiting for the doctor.
It stopped hurting. Or is it hurting still?
It stopped hurting.
Leave her alone. So we weren't too busy, so the doctor was able to see her.
She had quite a big gaping, what we call a laceration, which is a large cut that has a bit of a ragged edge to it, and it was quite deep. And I had a look at it initially to see if there was any glass left in the wound, but also to see that she hadn't done any other injuries to either the tendons or the muscles that might have needed a different treatment.
You've been very brave, haven't you? I
think
you've been a brave girl.
Yeah. Bring that curl
in
my bag.
We initially got the x-ray to look for pieces of glass that might have been left in the wound. And that allows us just to make sure we don't leave anything in that might cause an infection or cause problems later on.
All they needed to do was take the picture from two different angles. This young lady had other ideas. She was not keen on the x-ray.
No, but I can see a tiny dot there. So if it's in here, I need that side, you know, to see how deep and if there is anything, and that's why this one is the most important, do you know what I mean?
Despite the radiographer's best efforts, there's no way Ashadia is going to let her get the x-ray.
Just like that, look, put it there with that lady's hand.
Christmas or no Christmas, without that second x-ray, the team simply can't close the wound. Oh, Alfie, you've made my day.
Oh, you've made my day.
Doctor? He's not here yet.
Something keeps stabbing me in my finger.
Stick, 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 sticky, sticky, stick, stick.
Maybe I've got a bit of tinsels. Like, keeps getting me. Anyway.
Back to the matter at hand. I mean, foot. Josh was so fizzling with excitement for Christmas, he kicked a wall.
Don't trip. That's
and
it.
Now we're about to find out who wins at tote versus wall.
So,
I've broken it.
Can you see it? You have. How did you know? Did they
show? They showed me.
Did they? Okay.
There's a little crack just in front. It's there.
Brilliant.
Will I be able to play football or not?
In January you will, yes.
Yes!
We're still...
Because that's when I'll go back to school and play football.
I would say mid-Jan, you can start thinking about it. If your pain is all settled down, then you can go back to playing football.
So I might miss one or two matches.
Yeah, when does football start again?
Is it about the 12th of January? That's my estimate.
Okay, so...
Oh, 10th. Two days off.
Okay, so you might have to give it a week or so, but see how his pain is.
And although I tried when he got back to school not to let him play football, I have a feeling he was very sneaky and had a kick about when I wasn't there.
I did play football when I went back to school.
Oh, Josh, you know your mum's got to see this, don't you?
I'm Joshua Carlos.
Because there was a break, we put a metatarsal pad on.
Yes, we've got padding.
Just to try and reduce some of the weight-bearing load.
It's probably OA.
While Josh has an impromptu eye test, everyone works out what exactly a metatarsal pad is.
Metatarsal pads.
On a middle, right to middle toe.
The foamy circle you just stick there.
Underneath.
Yeah.
Well, that's that sorted.
Will they have to inject something in or not?
Nothing,
put a dressing on. Oh, dressing? Thought it was like an injection or something.
Don't worry, Josh. It's an injection-free Christmas for you.
We decided that he would require buddy strapping.
Have we done this then?
Kicked a wall.
So we strap the two toes together so that it's supported and stays nice and stable, and also just give it a bit of support and make it a little bit more comfortable.
How does that feel?
That feels fine.
Okay, just need to make sure that you have good circulation, so if you just keep squeezing it, make sure this keep warm and you keep, they're nice and pink and red.
Uh-huh.
All right then.
Thank you.
No worries. Thank you for being a star patient.
Yeah.
Hope you enjoy your Christmas dinner.
I will.
Considering it was Christmas Day, I can't praise Sheffield Children's A&E enough.
Free to go.
Free to go.
Yeah, thank you. No worries at all.
I'm the hopping king.
Go steady. Enjoy the rest of Christmas.
And I have to say, I did hop for a few days afterwards.
At least your walls will be safe for a few days, Mum.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, they're fantastic. Like, not one of them's mourning.
And a Merry Christmas to you too, Natalie. Hey up, Bruce Wayne's here.
Humphrey, who was dressed as Batman and was very pleased with himself on Christmas Day, arrived back in. He'd been in on Christmas Eve, so he would be what we call a returner, having fallen over and hit his chin on a toy box, which is an occupational hazard if you're a small child. And he'd had it cleaned and dressed the day before, but the dressing had come off and his wound had opened a bit.
Mind if you want to just take a second, please.
He's very energetic. He talks about having running power. He's very difficult to stop, and he's always jumping over things and falling off things, usually bounces off. It's the first big injury he's had.
I wonder how Humphrey had his mishap in the first place.
We had been tracking Santa across a map of the world, looking at when he might get to us.
Mummy's phone told us where Santa was.
When he was using all his running power, jumping up and down on the sofa, he took a tumble off into one of the boxes of toys.
No, you got to sit here, dude.
And a piece of plastic speared him on his chin. He decided he had to go back to the hospital halfway through his Christmas dinner, which is, again, typical of a toddler.
As a returner, Humphrey skips triage and goes straight to Nurse Sam for checkup. But while he waits for the doctor, he's got ants in his Christmas pants.
Don't, no, not that bit, not that step. Okay, you can sit on that chair. Because if it's a simple problem with a dressing or a cut, then often the nurses will manage it and they won't need to see a doctor at all. But Humphrey obviously is a very energetic kid.
Let's have a sit down. No, Humphrey.
Running around and jumping around.
Right, Humphrey, listen to me now. You need to just be a really good boy for me and calm down a bit, otherwise I'll have to just take you home.
And may well have bashed his chin again in the interim.
Not that step. Look under what your feet's on. Yeah, that's a lever. Don't press it.
I was there for a long, long time. I missed dinner and I missed...
Oh, what? We can't be having that, can we, Humphrey? Meanwhile, the team are trying to get a very reluctant Ashadia back in for that all-important second X-ray. Ashadia managed to give herself a nasty gash on her wrist with a champagne flute toasting with her sister. And without that second X-ray, they won't know if there's a piece of glass still in there or how to get it out if there is.
Fingers. Yeah. She's gonna like it, but it'll take 2 seconds and it won't hurt. So. I promise you it will not hurt.
Come on then.
So Susan, she built up a level of trust with Ashadia and with her mum from the first assessment, and that goes a long way to making the experience for the family stress-free as we can.
After a few
many attempts and a few hands, we managed to get the X-ray.
She was very brave, and she got, you know, she got some gifts at the end. So by the time she came to see me, she was very happy. Unfortunately, wasn't expecting any more gifts.
Can I have a little look at your sore hands? Very good. And what have you got here? Give you these.
Who gave you your presents?
Asharia's cut was quite big and gaping.
Can you touch your shoulder? Do that with this hand. Good. Oh, fantastic. And put it all the way back out again. Can you give me a high five? Well done. Can you give me a thumbs up?
You're brave, aren't you?
You know, she was quite lucky in that, you know, the tendons and the muscles weren't damaged.
There was no glass that we could see in the X-ray.
And it was all just the skin and the fat layer beneath that. That's always a nice part of my job, is reassuring people and saying, actually, this is okay, you know, we can fix this.
But when you say we, Michael, you mean the nurses will fix this.
I was very surprised when I did go to close the wound, armed with the additional staff. We went in already for quite a big battle to close this wound, and she was a different child, happy. She sat really nicely for us. She kept so still. I think I steri-stripped it and just put a dressing on. It was one of the easiest wounds. It was done so quickly. It was very nice to have all the additional help and support from the staff, but it really wasn't needed.
I do like a happy ending. See you later, ladies. Enjoy the rest of your Christmas.
I know we've had loads of Christmas decorations for quite a while.
Weeks before Christmas, the department is just decked head to toe.
I think the whole department had quite a Christmassy atmosphere.
I'm going to write happy Christmas. Okay. Do you know how to spell it? Easy, it's on there.
They've put out like Christmas trees for kids to stick stuff on and while they're waiting stockings. And yeah, things like that.
Colouring.
Stick something down quick while I've got this out for you.
You can't escape it.
I know what you mean, Dr. Richard. I often find myself dreaming of decorations.
I take a long time to wake up.
Are you awake yet?
I am awake.
Enjoy your brew while you can, guys. I can't imagine this peace and quiet at reception is going to last long.
The reception staff we have at the children's A&E department, they are amazing.
On Christmas Day, I'll be working alongside Carol. She's amazing.
We'd love to have a bacon sandwich, won't we?
She's very professional. She runs a tight ship. And then you've got Anne.
Anyway, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Who's their partner in crime. And they're a bit of a duo.
I missed you.
I missed you.
You need to tread very carefully around those two.
Christmas is still calm when Eva arrives with her dad and a sad face.
I can't believe that there's no bacon on this morning.
Hello. So on the Christmas day when Eva came in, she was really, really upset.
That's a sad face.
Yeah, she's got both fingers. We've just got... She's got fabulous splints all her fingers.
It makes no difference what time of year it is. They will always bring something new to table that you've not seen before.
On Christmas day, I got this present and it was a gymnastics one and it had a rainbow ribbon on the end.
So you're playing away nicely and next minute, as well, washing pots, being a good husband and all that. She started screaming.
And because the ribbon was wrapped around it, I pushed the ribbon off and that's when I got all the fiberglass on my finger.
She just stood with her hands and she couldn't touch her hands. Little splinters in her hands.
And then my dad tried scraping all the fiberglass off.
I got some splinters in my fingers. I might have said that before.
Sure, I've got them in my fingers as well.
OK. So. Right then, let's see what we can do.
And thought, if I don't like them, I know Eva's definitely not going to like them, so... Yeah, it needed sorting out, yeah, Christmas Day.
Yeah, well, hopefully you're working for us.
Hopefully we can get you sorted and back home again to your presents, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? Not be long. All right, just take a seat, nurse, I'll be with you.
Smash it, thank you.
Hello. Do you want to come through this way?
Well, Eva arrived in with her dad. We had quite a few dads come in on Christmas morning because I think the mums were all busy making dinner.
Hiya, Eva, my name's Liz.
She had had a toy that had broken in her hand.
What else did you get for Christmas? Did you open the rest of your presents?
Yeah.
Oh, the old side. What else did you get then?
I got an iPod.
An iPod? Wow, that's exciting.
A teddy.
And a teddy?
So especially in your fingers, anything across a joint, we would worry more about. Make sure the joint is safe, because developing infection in your hands can get pretty nasty sometimes. So that's the worry with a foreign body like this.
I'm not going to touch
you. I'm not going to touch it either.
I'm explaining it already.
I'm just going to have a little look. That's it. I'm not touching.
You can't see them because it's like glass.
Bless her, she was so upset, but she was a lot braver than I would have been in that situation, because imagine a small wound that you might have as an adult. She had multiple.
Oh dear, that's a bit rubbish, isn't it, Shimani? Good job you're all over it.
So we thought we'd x-ray it first, because some things are radio opaque, and we were hoping that this would be so we'd actually be able to see the extent of how much there was in there.
My mum said to my dad you could just see it glistening in the light.
She got some tweezers, like, you know, good mum, and she tried to get a few. She managed to get a couple of the bigger ones out, but then Eva started to get a little bit too upset.
It didn't feel good. It felt horrible.
Yeah, put a few plasters on it and that didn't seem to work. It weren't magic enough.
Then Dad asked me if I wanted to go to the hospital so they can get it out for me.
Hospital, it were. I just put my beer away.
OK, do you want to come round with me? We're not entirely sure whether this will actually show up on the x-ray or not.
Particularly the palms of your hands is a very sensitive area. Function and the sensation are both really important. You need it to heal as best as is possible.
You've had lots of x-rays, Eva. It's fine. In a little room, you put like a little piece of lead in front of you, and then boom, it's like a little photo with a little click. And then you can see through your skin, and you can see all your bones, but what you're hoping, because you've got like little splinters in your fingers, they're hoping the splinters will be able to see different to your skin. And then they'll know where how many's in there and what to do.
Sure, we'll find out soon enough. Meanwhile, it looks like Humphrey's calmed down just long enough to paint a festive rainbow.
Oh, you don't get a black in rainbows, though. Oh, well, I've never seen it.
Whilst we were there, a little band had formed. We weren't expecting it.
So the junior doctors that were working on Christmas Day had planned to bring in their instruments for an impromptu carol service.
Because we've got to know each other over these months, and we were just chatting, I was like, let's play some music. And obviously the consultant in charge was, she's always up for a bit of a laugh.
Because we had gaps between patients, we did have a chance to have a sing-along every now and again.
That was the lighter side of A&E.
It was great. It was a little treat for us.
We just needed some male voices. There was no men.
All in all, it sounded okay.
Is that Santa on phone? Tell him Eva's got fibreglass in her fingers.
Listen, if they get hold of your hand to lay it down flat, don't be scared, they're not there to hurt you, yeah?
Dad was really good at explaining everything to her and telling her what the doctors and nurses wanted to do and how she could help them to help her.
See, I'm touching him now and not hurting, is it?
Could you not touch him where it is?
I know. Well, hopefully they might have some special cream. Fingers crossed.
Come on, Dad, first rule to getting fibreglass in your fingers, you don't go crossing them. Sheffield Children's A&E is becoming a bit of a destination this Christmas. What's going on with Humphrey's face? What is it with chins? Where did Santa get to?
Sure, he went through them double doors.
Who did that to you, George? And what will the doctor do about Eva's fingers?
If it's raw fibreglass, it's nasty stuff.
If Deirdre says it's nasty stuff, this isn't going to be pretty. It's a Christmas of calamities down at Sheffield A&E, and Humphrey's chin's one of them calamities.
Have you had your dinner yet?
Yeah, we came halfway through it. Just because he said he wanted to come. He said, shall we go now and have our pudding after?
Well, we had no good deep breaths.
He saw Sam, and Sam thought his wound looked a little bit gapey, a little bit wet and scabby. The difficulty there is, what do you put the child through to try and close what we would consider a minor cut? She wasn't sure, so she asked me to come and review him.
In the meantime, Sam brought Humphrey a little gift from Santa.
Oh, what is it?
Hot Wheels.
Wow.
Worth a visit, wasn't it?
That was.
Is that all right? Well, she won't be too long.
Yeah, that's right. Brilliant, thank you.
It's a bedtime at home.
It's not bedtime, sweetheart. It's the middle of the day.
Can I get down now?
Can you get down? Well, I think we're just waiting for a doctor to come and look at your chin.
Do you want to look at a book?
Oh, hello, Humphrey.
We've got a book to look.
How are you, my dear? Are you having a bad Christmas day or are you having a nice Christmas day?
Nice.
Nice, that's good. Well, we'll try and get you home so that you have an even better day in a minute.
There were options about what to do with this, but equally with a cut on your face, there's options what to do a year down the line, 2 years down the line, 3 years down the line, if somebody really hates the way a particular scar looks.
Did you have a Brussels sprouts? You should have those, they make you Trump. They're awesome. Right, so where's me gloves?
Children's faces usually heal absolutely brilliantly, but it's also why the cut would have bled like mad when it first happened. It's because the blood supply is so good to it.
Let's have a look at your lovely face. Is it hurting? But you're really brave and tough, aren't you?
I don't think it's hurting now, is it?
I think it's probably hurting when people poke at it and annoy you, isn't it? So anything coming out of it, any ooze, or has it just gaped a little bit?
Well, it hasn't sort of dried off at all.
Okay, and it only happened yesterday?
Yeah, about 1 o'clock yesterday.
And you went douche onto what?
A toy box, a plastic toy box that then shattered.
Okay, all right, my darling Batman. Can you lie down for me in a Batman's daily?
Deirdre was lovely. So she had a look at Humphrey's chin.
Now, with Humphrey's wound, half of his wound came together nicely and stayed together with the Steri-Strips, but the other half was under a bit more tension, a bit more stretch, and that's why it popped open.
The gapy bit at the bottom won't come together unless it's done surgically, like cutting out the nasty tissue and bringing nice, clean, new tissue together.
It was a nice, clean wound. He was quite happy. There was no signs of any other injury.
I don't think we could do anything for that without an anaesthetic. To revise that wound, I think we'd have to put him to sleep, which is potentially over-egging
we
it
don't,
for a little mark.
I don't think you're going to need that. But I think you can have a nice, tough
let
scar.
Me have a quick scooter ride and I'll see if Max Fax are here.
The Max Fax doctor, which is short for maxillofacial. Maxillary actually means your jaw, facial means your face.
Oh, they're gone.
Oh, dear. It looks like Max Fax may have left the building. Christmas Day is well underway, though festive calamities fill the bay. The Christmas spirit is here to...
Hello, A&E, doctor speaking.
Generally irritate Dr. Richard.
There was definitely a few who go into overdrive.
Most festive time ever.
Which is not fair of me, because it makes me seem a bit more grumpy, I think. But I'm not.
Richard. He's grumpy anyway, he'll be fine.
There's quite a few strong characters, and I'm sure you'll come across one or two of them.
We found a couple of sneaky elves.
Anything not to wear a uniform.
I presume they'd do it for any kind of holiday.
Richard wasn't especially Christmassy.
All right, I'll put the hat on.
Someone's got to be Scrooge. He's going to hate me for saying that.
Oh, OK. Saying that I'm grumpy, then. Well, you got to accept it sometimes.
Richard? Oh, he's Christmassy.
If you say so, Laura. What's this? Excited kids landing on their face. They're like buses in Sheffield.
Are we booking in?
Just like, yeah, he was a bit excited, jumping around, falling over, split his chin open. It's quite a common thing we see in kids. But he's got his reason because he's excited for Christmas and then he's earned himself a trip to A&E.
What date of birth is it, please? Hello.
Which date of birth?
February 21st.
Well done, yeah, 2011.
How old are you?
2008.
But Josiah isn't your average accident-prone child. This is his first visit to an A&E department.
So you've not done too bad, Josiah, if this is the first time you've ever been here, are you? Really? That's quite good, I think.
And it seems Josiah likes to do some thinking too, and not about the little things in life.
If Earth were the star, wouldn't it be even better?
Josiah Blake!
It has to be quite bad for them to come in on Christmas Day because there's lots going on. Parents may or may not want to take him in.
What does it look like?
It's an open gash. It's literally it? Split.
I won't look now because the doctor's going to take it all down anyway.
Yeah. It's quite a dramatic thing because they all bleed a lot. They've seen quite a worrying thing because they've just seen everything coming out. And by the time they get to hospital, parents have stopped the bleeding. In most cases, they're relatively easy to manage. We just need to make sure they're not too deep.
So one little... episode of disobedience can actually change everyone's plans in a matter of minutes.
Oh, wow. Happy Christmas, Josiah.
No one wants to be poorly at Christmas, least of all children. I mean, that's what Christmas is about, isn't it?
Are you making new plans, Dad?
Let's get this kiddie mended.
Josiah Blake?
Yep. Oh, it's a double whammy. Josiah's got really happy Richard to fix him.
He's earned himself a trip to A&E, having to get himself patched up, not exactly what he expected.
And because I was so excited about it, I was running and skipping, but then I tripped and then I bumped on my chin.
Like, why are you jumping around and sort of late in the evening, but then you remember it's Christmas, he's got an excuse. Not that he needs an excuse, but...
You shouldn't be up at this time of night, mate.
Well, this is it. I mean, I last left him in the bathroom brushing his teeth.
Don't know whether he got in a bit of trouble for that or not.
So wasn't knocked out at all? Oh, yeah.
Oh, Richie, I think that's going to need a stitchy. Meanwhile, Vet Deirdre's got her hands right full.
So we need to finish the Pringles so that we can pose the Tyrannosaurus reindeer. In the fullness of his glory, that's a bit big, though.
A few festive moments and some hand-washing later.
Job diddly done. There you go. He's just got a roll of plastic bags up his bum.
The big question is, has anybody seen Santa?
There's Santa!
So we have some special guests during Christmas Day.
Santa Claus always visits the children's hospital, and there's plenty of gifts for all the kids.
And the children's eyes are like on stalks. It's a joy to watch the children. They can't believe that Father Christmas is actually in the hospital.
And his wife, Mrs. Christmas, I think her name's Mary Christmas, but she got a bit lost after she was chatting to somebody. So Santa went round to see a few other people and left poor Mrs. Claus behind.
I have no idea which way. I'm sure he went through them double doors. Yeah, so, but I don't know where he's gone, I'm sorry.
And one of the elves pointed her in the right direction and she eventually caught up with him, I think.
A dicky bird told me that not all presents are delivered by Santa on day. What about when he's not there?
We do have toys to give out to the children over Christmas.
So all the children that came in on Christmas Day, they all get a present.
Thank you.
Got your medicines for home. I've yes, also please. Got you a present from Santa.
Oh, my word. Thank you so much.
Santa does deliver those toys to the play specialist cupboard with the poorly children's names on them. And then we just have to go and hand deliver them, like little Christmas elves. George?
Yeah?
We've got you a little present from Santa. Oh.
George came in with suspected croup, but for all intents and purposes, it seems he's already on the mend.
He was full of beans and happy with his toy that we gave him. Just 1 minute. Let's see if my big scissors will squeeze in.
He'd had croup before, so I think Dad was thinking it was croup again.
My wife's a vet. She listened to his chest just now. Said he's got a crackle, said, come down.
Has he had that barking cough then?
Yes, yeah. He's had it most of the night.
So initially I wasn't very worried about him. It causes swelling of your throat and cold air helps. So normally when children have croup, they come into A&E and they've been outside, it's been cold. So they're normally better by the time they come in.
For the doctor, you don't even know what to do.
What I like about working with children is that they take the situation as it is. So if they feel poorly, they feel poorly. And then the minute they feel better, they're better. Bouncing around the soft play area and jumping off the ceiling.
And I admire that in a child.
Where's this going to go, George?
Do you remember where this goes? Not on your tummy. It goes in your ear. Which one should we do? That one. Good boy.
George Mellini.
Everything's pointing to a simple case of croup, but Laura still does all the thorough checks just to make sure that nothing's been missed.
I'm Laura, I'm one of the doctors.
Oh, this is Laura.
Laura.
Yeah, Laura.
Who's this?
Never mind that. Pause. Oh, I didn't realise I could do that. Anyway, I can see trouble ahead. Where's that dumper truck that Charlie gave him in the play area?
Dad had left it there because I don't think he realised it was for him. And by the time they went back out, another child was playing with it.
Why have we got a sad face now?
He was playing with a toy out there, another kid's got it, that's all. Oh,
which one was it?
Just the little dumper truck thing. Oh. Didn't want to take up with the kid, though. It's Christmas.
It's not the one they gave you?
Yeah.
The yellow one?
Yeah.
Oh, no. And after such a perfect visit to the hospital, He seems to be on the mend. He's waiting for his medicines, but now he's not got his dumper truck.
We couldn't find him another dumper truck.
Doctor.
Should we go and see Father Christmas as well?
Doctor.
Should we come in soon? Okay.
Doctor.
All right, I'm on.
So we found him something else.
Wow.
Not this one instead.
What do you say?
Not a problem. It was more noisy, probably more irritating.
My toy.
That's your toy, isn't it? Yeah, this one's your toy, George. What is that?
I feel a bit bad for Dad about how noisy the toy was afterwards. Didn't quite realise how loud it was.
How are you feeling?
Good.
You're feeling good.
I love presents.
Do you?
What can we say about Helen? Helen is not a Christmassy fan.
It's because it keeps saying I'm not right.
But she's trying very hard.
She's trying very hard. Yes,
I think we make more of an effort with the kids.
Have you got a car?
He has, yes.
Yeah. That one. Look at my neck.
And it's like you've got your family Christmas, but you've got your work family Christmas.
Yeah.
And then you're still here to do a job at the end of the day as well.
We have this medicine.
Good boy.
Oh, you are a good boy.
Is that nice?
Ah, are you tired?
Not slept a great
deal. I bet those batteries are taken out before they run out. Enjoy the rest of your Christmas, Dad. We've still got a brace of chins to fix and that age-old question.
Sorry? What is it? What's my magic about the cream? What is it?
Are you five?
I'm four.
You're four.
Oh, but
there's
I am in Y1.
Y1?
Yes, Gemma.
Oh.
Yes. They're just funny. You know, kids are just funnier than adults are.
Pig.
Pig, you can spell pig, yeah.
Yeah. That was some funny things.
Yeah,
that
was some funny things.
Why? Pickler.
Get down off that side. Pickler. Good boy.
Pickler.
The thought of working with adults scares me.
I wonder if Humphrey saw any adults on Christmas Day.
I saw some boxes and then we got better.
So I would be putting a bit of Savlon or Germaline, anything like that, just no pseudocreme. Okay? So you have to let her put the cream on, okay, Batman? All right? All right?
Look who Sam's found loitering around the nurse's station. It's only one of them there MaxFax doctors.
We saw another doctor who came and gave some more specialist advice.
He's just been here a short while.
You're up all night.
Oh, no, can I have a little look at your chair?
You're such a fibber, you haven't up and up all
night.
You slept soundly.
Chin up. Yeah.
You're happy to leave it be? Yeah, I didn't think it was worth it. There you go.
She agreed with us to keep it clean, let it heal by itself, and everything would be fine. We saw, you know, every specialty we could have wanted to see.
And I saw the nurses too.
All the staff were so friendly and it didn't put a dent in the Christmas spirit at all. So couldn't really have been any better.
Merry Christmas, guys. Meanwhile, festive beans, they're good for your heart. The more you eat, the more you...
You just jumped on TV.
Oops.
Yeah, oops. Good job, you can't smell, isn't it?
It's always nice to have parents who are on board and who can throw in the jokes even when their child's unwell.
We just don't know whether fiberglass is radio opaque or not. It'll be little flakes, like slivers of glass.
Hello
my dear.
Right.
Can we have a look at your hand?
And we had a discussion as a team about whether to get it out, but there were just so many fragments that we thought painkillers would be the best option and trialing a magnesium sulfate cream.
Which is a really old treatment. It's like a paste that you apply to the wound over a foreign body.
To see whether that would help draw it out.
Yeah, that's the only way I could think of doing it.
I'm not sure it really works.
You've got to be honest.
We don't know why it works, but it just works.
And if you say so, Kath, that'll do for me.
There's nothing to see on the x-ray, but we're not sure whether fiberglass would show up anyway. Glass does, but wood doesn't.
We're all sure thinking you might have got a big magnifying glass or something.
If you were to go in looking for a foreign body, the dissection required is really detailed. And as her dad said, if we had a massive magnifying glass, we might be able to see tiny slivers. But the question is how painful would it be to remove them? And usually it sheds by itself.
After all, cheers. Thank you.
It's painful for a day or two and it goes away.
Look, so this is your finger.
And when I saw my hand, I really liked it because I've never seen inside of my hand before.
And because you're still growing, you've got all your growth plates. So when you get older and you become an adult like Daddy, these will be whole bits of bone. But you've got these little bits which let your fingers grow longer with you as you get taller.
Instead of talking to me, she was talking to Eva, which I really liked because it's Eva's hand. I found it really important that she was telling Eva and not me.
Bit of cream and a bandage, it's all done. Then we're going home. Yeah. Calm down. I know I'm okay.
There was great interaction between them and Dad was lovely and patient.
Don't get scared, you're all right. Yeah, big deep breaths. And blow your nose out through your mouth. Yeah. Big deep breaths.
Interestingly, he actually had some in his hand as well, as he said.
I've got them in my fingers as well. I've got a couple of my fingers, I can feel them.
I've got them in my finger, I can feel them when I move mine around.
Right.
Now, I've got some in my finger out from the same one, yeah. It's not the first time I've had it, so.
Is it not? Oh, you should have said, Dad.
It's just a cream look. Why don't you put a cream on?
Just a tiny bit of cream like that I'm going to put on your finger.
And I'll make the splinters come out.
She was very frightened at first, and I think having to go for x-ray and having all of that, by the time I actually seen her and dressed her and treated her, she was actually fine.
You'll still be able to eat your sprouts though, won't you?
So Kathy would have answered any follow-up questions from Dad.
How does it work then? I mean, how does it draw it out? How does it work?
It draws it out from underneath the skin. Brings it to the surface. That's the plan.
Yeah, but what causes it to come to the surface? Or what is it? What's the magic about the cream? What does it?
It's a drawing.
Oh, right.
Cream.
Yeah, that's it, Kath. Baffling with science.
God love Kathy, honestly. She's brilliant.
OK, is that fine? Is that OK?
That's it, all perfect.
She's the top dog. Plus, trots around in her heels, so a bit of comedy.
The magic cream. I still don't know how it works, but, yeah, it works.
She's here a lot.
And then the receptionist let her pick one of the elves hanging up behind.
Would you like one of our elves?
So now we've got another buddy in the house, so to speak, so that's another elf we've got to look after.
Oh, there we go. You're very welcome. We don't want another visit back to A&E today.
No, not today. I want Yorkshire puddings to go and cook. That's my job, my one job at day.
That's one thing my mother-in-law won't be doing, Yorkshire pudding. She says they don't belong on Christmas dinner.
My mother-in-law is exactly the same.
ED Clinic. Please.
Yeah, you want him back on Wednesday,
yeah.
But we're already overbooked for Wednesday.
And Wednesday was busy, and the cafe just said, don't worry about it, come and see me anyway, which were quite cool.
If you can't be cool at Christmas, when can you be cool? Come on, Dad, Eva's got a bowl of sprouts to tuck into. Ah, we've had lots of happy endings today. We've only got Josiah left.
OK, that's all right. No vomiting. Normal self.
Normal
okay.
Self.
You know, he's fine. He got home. He had Christmas Day.
And that's got a good closure. Very nice.
Not a problem, as long as he didn't fall over and do it again.
We were incredibly lucky that we didn't have any serious or nasty cases come in. That makes a massive difference to everybody's morale on Christmas Day.
See me?
Hi, Dad.
Normally, we're really so busy we haven't got time to think. But Christmas Day was such a nice, relaxed day.
We've had a great team working at Christmas this year.
Just hear the sleigh bells tingling, tingling, tingling too.
Merry Christmas from the Emergency Department of Sheffield Children's Hospital, and I wish you a safe and healthy and happy new year.
No, we'd ideally not like to see you here, but we will be here if you need us.
So I'd like to wish you all a massive happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas!
Christmas!
A very happy Christmas.
Just a merry, merry Christmas.
A happy Christmas.
A merry Christmas to you all.
From the bottom of my heart, merry Christmas.
Just like to wish happy Christmas to everybody, from me and the Blackburn family. Brilliant, thank you.
it would seem wrong. So, yeah, just Merry Christmas. Terrible at that.
They do say it's the thought that counts. Merry Christmas, everybody. Yes, that is fake snow.